Dogumentary TV, producing the best breed documentaries on YouTube.
Well, my name is Christian Ortiz. I'm from Tustin, California. It's in Orange County. And I'm here today because it's a Pharaoh Hound national show going on. But it's also like a SoCal lure coursing. There's all these different side hounds here. We have Rhodesian Ridgebacks, Whippets, Beeson Hounds, and of course, Pharaoh Hounds. My dog's name is Tenoch. His AKC name is Nefertemu Ultimate Up Tilt. When I got him, it was tough kind of raising them because they're very energetic dogs. I've had a dachshund before that, so they're very, you know, docile. They're not too, crazy, hyper. This one, I mean, he's great because I'm an active person. You know, he runs with me, chase him around the park. Just love how he's very prey driven against, but once he sees rabbits, lizards, anything, he just goes for it. He's a dog, and that's what I wanted in, you know, a breed. That's why I got this one. I've had him now for about 2.5 years, but I had my eye on that breed now, since 2010. Only reason why I didn't get him since then was I had a different dog around that time. I had a Chiweenie, but a very neurotic, jealous dog. I was just scared that if I got a Pharaoh Hound, well, she would just lose her will to live and just keel over and die. So I waited. I'm a huge history buff. So one day I was just looking at encyclopedia of dogs, all of them. And the Pharaoh Hound just caught my attention. Straight lines. They had that Anubis look. And once I saw them, I'm thinking, oh my God, that looks like Anubis, you know, the Egyptian, almost like the Egyptian jackal, the Egyptian god of death, you know? Obviously god of death, but he's like, judges you before you cross over, and I like that. I just like the way he looks. Didn't know what to expect when I got him, but he's actually pretty clean. You know, he doesn't destroy anything. He jumps around, runs around here and there, but he's actually very respected property. He doesn't chew on anything. What I like about lure coursing is it digs into pretty much the dog's instincts. And when I got the Pharaoh Hound, I wanted to make sure I maximize everything that he's capable of doing. You know, and that's using his hunting instinct. You know, so they're not, you know, chasing around real rabbits. They are chasing white bags that, you know, would simulate rabbits. It's just amazing to see how they're just running around just chasing this rabbit. And you know how they're getting better each time they do it. But I'm gonna take advantage of it like the first 2.5 years. When they first start off, all they do is they just chase, you know, so they're always behind the rabbit or the bag, and they follow along with it very well. But right when they hit about 4 years old, they turn into pretty much official hunters. They just start anticipating, you know, so instead of following it, they'll be cutting it off like on the pass, or they'll be going left, or just anticipating for it to come to them. Right now there's two judges. So they're just watching the dog, how they just chase the rabbit, what their endurance, how quick they are. The big thing is they just want to keep on like seeing how they're following the rabbit all the way through. And of course, once they finish, if you're looking around like all the other dogs, sometimes you see dogs just veer off, they stop, they come back to mom or dad. You know, so the ones that actually do win at the very end, they chase the rabbit all the way down. So it's a point system. So each time they run, each judge can give them 40 points. So it's 80 points altogether if there's, you know, two judges. The best they can get is 40, you know, for each one of them. Usually, like when you see, you know, underperforming dog, when there's like three of them, it's 36 and below. 40 is like the sweet spot that you want to go for. If you have a side hound in general, especially with a Pharaoh Hound, lure coursing is a great thing to do just for like just to test out their instincts And because they're all natural hunters in a way, you know, so this is really the best way to get them out there and just let them dig in and use their instincts. I mean, you can go out, you know, in the fields and try to, you know, hunt rabbits here and there, but I mean, you got to deal with, you know, the mess of actually getting a rabbit, cook him up and all that. But with this, you know, you come out here, nice day at the park, chase them around, you know, let them do their thing, you know, being like pack hunters in a way. Because when they do a race, they're racing against two other dogs or by themselves. But it's a beautiful thing when you see three dogs just racing, trying to get this, this rabbit and go from there. You know, so, but if you do want to get a Pharaoh Hound, just get ready for it. I mean, you do have to be an active person yourself too, because they are very demanding. You know, they want to get out there. They do need their exercise. So it's not for any, you know, you can't just leave them at home and that's it. They will definitely get your attention. They demand it. If you want to go into lure coursing, you can look it up like on Google, lure coursing. Sometimes there's like clubs nearby. I personally went through lure coursing, SoCalLureCoursing.com. That's a good one if you're in Southern California, because they always do different events just around the whole SoCal area. Or you can even go on AKC.org. And there's, you know, different pages in there. Like you can see lure coursing. There's also like obedience, rally. There's many different things. Even like for gun dogs, when you have golden retrievers, there's a lot of different things you can look at. Lucky, lucky, lucky me. Lucky.